Qatari. There's also been about 277 flood rescues. Now, unfortunately, too many of those have been people driving through floodwaters. As the SES says, if it's flooded, forget it. And also to those that are doing the wrong thing and driving through those floodwaters, the SES is imploring people to think about their volunteers who need to go in and recover them and their vehicles. It's extremely dangerous conditions along the mid-north coast and down to the Hunter at the moment. So the SES and all authorities are urging people just...
We're driving beside the wheel River, and it was becoming communities will be preparing for that eventuality and should be keeping a very close eye on the SES when it comes to evacuation warnings and orders.
So, Jake, with your travels this morning, when you have been able to get through and see what's happening, you talk there about people preparing. What sort of things are you seeing? What are you hearing from people who you've coming across as you make your way around the region?
Yeah, most of the main roads, like the Pacific Highway I've driven on a bit today, that's in fairly good condition. But when you get out to the smaller roads out in these sorts of townships like Raymond Terrace, for example, livestock is a major problem. There's a lot of low-lying paddocks with horses, cattle and the like. And I was just speaking to a lady earlier who was concerned she was going to her farm, moving large amounts of livestock.
Overwhelmed, very, very. It's a lot, takes a lot to get through it, but... we'll get there. We're going to stay positive. We were actually home and trying to get everything sorted. We've been watching the weather reports and then, yeah, all of a sudden it just hit. It was too late. We got what we could out and we ended up having to get the fireys out to rescue us at like 2 o'clock in the morning. So.